phrase. I was talking about the assumption and the types of hints that you are going to use regularly in the practical application. And a heat transfer through rectangular fin. What you are going to study here, I am going to brief it out first once again. That the temperature distribution and heat flow through fins of only two geometries. One is rectangular fin and a round fin. That is spine, you call it as. Only those two are there for syllabus. Not any other geometry other than these two. You have to understand that I am going to take a simple geometry and I am making an assumption. The heat flows in only one direction, not in the other two direction. And there are boundary conditions to be considered, the temperature boundary condition and convective heat boundary condition that you are going to consider. So here the example that I am going to give, this is the spine, that is a circular fin, you call it as spine or circular fin, having sufficient length L and temperature T, and this periphery is pi D, and cross sectional area is pi D squared by 4, and it is the diameter, and T 0 is the base temperature and T infinity is the air temperature that we are going to see. Similar way the rectangular fin is taken. And I am going to take the elemental area here, and the heat is flowing in this direction from wall, and the fin is attached to a wall, and the heat is flowing from qx to qx plus dx in the direction of x, and x is x from the base and dx is the elemental area that I am going to take. Okay, so that is the length L, and if you consider the area, x into t is the area, and volume if you consider, and b you have to multiply. So there you will get the elemental volume. So there are fin with rectangle and fin with circular profile. I am going to consider only two. So this is the temperature distribution already explained over the length of the fin. If it is a rectangular fin or circular fin, looks alike, and it is having a temperature distribution in this fashion. So analysis of heat from fin surface made out of following assumption. Already I read out these assumptions in previous class. Again, the conduction equation, the heat balance equation on elemental area is given. Energy in the left phase is equal to energy out in the right phase plus energy lost by convection. Already given this, and how much is the energy conducted in the left phase from the wall where the fin is attached? How much heat is going out with convection heat transfer at the end. It is noted that differential area for convection is the product of perimeter, and the elemental length, that is differential length dx. When you combine this quantity, you will get the energy balance equation. So this is energy balance equation k d square t by dx square plus minus hpa t minus t infinity is equal to 0. So if you divide this by ka throughout, you'll get hb by ka t minus t infinity is equal to 0. Put theta is equal to this, you have to remember theta is equal to t minus t infinity. I am just putting the quantity, the temperature at any point in the fin minus of the ambient temperature is called as theta here upwards. D square t by dx square minus hp k a theta. So if you assume that m square is equal to hp by k a, then the equation turns to d square minus m square theta is equal to 0. So it has got two roots, therefore d is equal to plus or minus m. From this I am going to the solution for this equation, the differential equation, as you seen there, that is equal to theta is equal to a e to the power of minus mx plus b e to the power of mx. This called this equation 3.9. Substituting these values in the above equation, that e to the power of mx is equal to hyperbolic cos and plus of sine, and it is the equivalent values are the exponential values are given here, and this is also taken in cos hyperbolic and minus of sine hyperbolic for minus e to the power of mx. So that you substitute in 3.9, these two quantities you have to substitute in 3.9. You will get an equation like this: a cos mx plus a sin mx, a sin hyperbolic mx plus b cos hyperbolic mx minus b sin hyperbolic mx. This is how you are going to get the general solution for that. So once you get this, separate only cos hyperbolic mx separately, a plus b separated out and multiplied by cos hyperbolic mx, a minus b sin hyperbolic mx. Put a plus b is equal to c1, a minus b is equal to c2. Then finally equation you get theta is equal to, that is temperature distribution equation is equal to c1 cos hyperbolic mx plus c2 sin hyperbolic mx is called 3.10. This is having a constant c1 and c2. You have to find out the constant c1 and c2 for various cases. What are the cases to be considered for finding out the heat transfer temperature distribution and also heat transfer with fins which are having a long fin, finite length, infinitely long, and finite length and convection tip at the end and insulated fin. There are four cases. This is a list out of different physical situation may be considered. Because why only the four physical situation? You cannot have more than four physical situation in practical. Practically, we assume that these are the broadly assumed and almost they are similar. Heat dissipation from a very infinitely long fin, that is L is equal to infinity, fin with a convection tip, and fin heat dissipation from fin insulated at the tip, heat dissipation from a finite fin having a finite length or long fin, you can say. So three cases. First case I am going to take, that heat dissipation from an infinitely long fin. Suppose using boundary condition, temperature at a base of the fin equal to the temperature of the surface to be and which is the fin is attached. So therefore, well, assume the boundary condition T is equal to T0. Here T is equal to T0, x is equal to 0. And in terms of theta, you can write T minus of T infinity is equal to T theta minus of T infinity. Therefore, theta is equal to T naught, T theta 0. Already assumed that in the previous slide I have shown while deriving the equation 10.0, that theta is equal to, here I have taken, here theta is equal to T minus T infinity I have taken. Same thing I am going to use that. So theta is equal to T minus T 0, and also theta naught is equal to T 0 minus T infinity. Okay, this is what. So this is theta is equal to theta naught. This is the boundary condition. Theta is equal to theta naught at x is equal to 0. Substituting in equation 3.10. What is that? That I am going to write equation 1.3.10 is. So this is C1 cos hyperbolic mx plus C2 sin hyperbolic mx. So this is the condition. This is 3.10. I'll call it this. Equation. So this is the temperature distribution equation for various different conditions. Temperature at the end of the an infinite long fin equal to the top surrounding. It means if the fin is very long, the temperature almost equal to the surrounding temperature only at the end. So therefore, it is taken as T is equal to T infinity. Second case is T is equal to T infinity at x is equal to L, that is equal to infinity. It means very long fin. So in terms of temperature, again you have to write, this is T minus T infinity minus again T infinity, that's equal to 0. So at x is equal to, what is the temperature? At x is equal to, when L is equal to L tends to infinity, temperature theta is equal to theta naught. This equal to 0. That's what the boundary condition is. because for a long period, that's what see, x is equal to infinity, t is equal to t infinity, and this is the, these are the temperature distribution various values of m value. So m1, m2, m3, I'll take up that one example. What is m and why you have to take a different material and surrounding properties with the temperature distribution. Okay, see, the substituting this boundary condition in the equation 3.9, this is one equation, and the equation 3.9 is also there. That is theta is equal to a e to the power of mx plus b e to the power of minus mx. This is equation 3.9. So substitute these boundary condition in equation 3.9. What do you get? So you will get first boundary condition, theta is equal to theta naught, x is equal to 0. What is get? So theta is equal to x is equal to 0, e to the power of mx is only, you will get a. Okay, next e to the power of mx is 1, then you will get b. So therefore theta is equal to theta naught at x is equal to 0. So this is what you are going to get. I shown it here. Okay, and using a second boundary condition, theta is equal to theta naught at x is equal to infinity. This boundary condition I used, and next I am using this boundary condition, this in the this equation. So L is equal to infinity means what? Theta is equal to theta naught, L is equal to infinity means, so this is 0 plus B you get. So B is equal to theta naught. Therefore, B is equal to theta naught. Substitute this in any one of the in the above boundary conditions, what do you get? So you'll get an equation, theta is equal to, this is the first boundary condition solution, this is the first boundary condition solution is there, and this is second boundary condition solution. So after substituting these two values, A is equal to 0. In 3.9, what do you get? Theta is equal to, and this is equal to 0 plus b e to the power of mx. So, taking theta is equal to theta naught e to the power of mx from this equation, you will get a solution. Theta is equal to theta naught e to the power of mx. So what is the temperature distribution? Theta by theta naught is equal to e to the power of mx minus mx. So what is that? Theta is equal to t minus t infinity divided by theta naught minus t infinity to the power minus mx. This is given in page number 50, it is given in data handbook. You can also refer that. Okay, this is the temperature distribution for FinVin is having a very long infinite length. Heat flow through the fin can be evaluated from Fourier's law of thermal conduction. From the expression of temperature distribution, already you have got expression of temperature distribution. I summarize the rise. I'll just clean this board. This equation, so this can be written as T is equal to, this you cross multiply, what you get? T is equal to T infinity plus of T0 minus T infinity e to the power of minus mx from this equation. I have written like this, and that is also shown there. T0 minus of T infinity e to the power of, you differentiate this equation, what you get? Dt by dx. At what value x is equal to 0? Then what do you get here? T infinity is 0 minus m t 0 minus t infinity and e to the power of minus mx. This is the value you get after differentiation. And when x is equal to 0, what do you get? You will get minus, this is at x is equal to 0. I have not put limit here. This is equal to minus m t 0 minus t infinity. So this is what the dt by dx value you get. So dt by dx value I have had at the fin. So therefore q fin, that is heat flow in fin, can be taken as ka kac dt by dx, conductivity into cross section area dt by dx at x is equal to 0. You have to substitute this equation and dt by dx is equal to substitute it. What you get? So this is minus minus become plus ka m time t by t 0 minus of t infinity. That's what I got there. And put m is equal to hp by ka and you'll get square root of hp ka and t 0 minus t. So this is also given in data and book. You can refer it. Equation 3.12 is also given in data and book. You can also refer it. Okay. This complete the case 1. Go to the, this is the heat transfer, this is the heat flow equation and the temperature distribution equation. Both are derived for the case 1. This is temperature distribution. This one is Q fin heat flow equation. Similarly, I have to derive these two equations, how I derived temperature distribution and heat flow equation. Similarly, I have to derive for case 2 and 3. 2, 3 and 4. Okay. I'll go back to the case 2. And I told you, various values of M. What is ML1? Suppose you consider a box having a different material attached to them, having same geometry but different material attached to them. Different material means what? Conductivities are different. Having the same thermal convection, the convective heat transfer coefficient, having same geometry but materials are different. Materials are different. One is a ceramic rod, another is a aluminum rod, another is a copper rod, another one is a metal rod or iron rod. Like that, it is attached in a box and how they are equated. So this is how they are ML1, M1, M2, L2 and M3, L3. Just temperature distribution, how it is plotted. Already a graph previously I shown. This is how the ratio is going to be taken care of, because the periphery remains same, convective heat transfer remains same, cross sectional area remains same, but length L1, L2, L3 are varying with conductivity K1, K2, K3. This is the ratio I am going to just. You can just go through that. Final equation will get K1 by L1 square, K2 by L2 square, K3 by L3 square. What do you understand from this is rate of heat flow through the solid can be compared by substituting just conductivity in this, and you will come to know how the depend on the length, how the same length if you consider, then how the conductivity will vary the heat flow. That also you can by having arrangement in a box. Okay, coming to the next second fin is having a convective heat convective the condition at the tip, that is convection at the tip, using a first boundary condition. That is, what is the first boundary condition? When x is equal to 0, t is equal to t naught. When x is equal to L, t is equal to t infinity. So with the convective heat transfer boundary condition, h at this point, surrounding temperature is t infinity. This is base and this is tip attached to a wall, and this length is L. It means having a finite length. So then what you get? Theta is equal to theta naught at x is equal to 0 in terms of theta. At x is equal to L, also you get the terms, the first and second boundary condition that I am going to use. Another boundary condition that I am going to, considering the convective boundary condition, it means how do you consider the convective boundary condition? This is the first boundary condition, theta is equal to theta naught at x is equal to 0. X is equal to 0. And the second boundary condition is that this is not x is equal to L, this is x is equal to 0, it's supposed to be. It is not the x is equal to L, that's a mistake. So then this is the equation 10. The second boundary condition is that how much of heat is getting conducted, that is minus Ka dT by dx is equal to h into a. Again here you have to use the test theta delta t. at x is equal to L. This is at x is equal to L. So I can write this equation minus k d theta by dx, x is equal to L, is equal to ha theta, x is equal to L. You know that theta is equal to t minus t0, is equal to t0 minus t infinity. Like that you are going to take, re-equating. So the area of cross section I am going to consider because of the tip, area of cross section. AC means area of cross section. Using a boundary condition, what do you get? In the above equation, first you have to use this boundary condition to write that. What do you get? You will get C1 is equal to theta naught at x is equal to 0. And substituting back on that equation and differentiating the same equation here. First boundary condition is C1 is equal to theta naught you get. Why? If you substitute x is equal to 0 in this, this sign hyperbolic 0 is 0 only. Sign 0 is 0. Here 1 you will get, C1 is equal to theta naught you get. That's what I have written. C1 is equal to theta naught. Theta is equal to theta naught, x is equal to L. So therefore, substitute back into that, you will get theta is equal to theta naught cos hyperbolic mx plus C2 sin hyperbolic mx. It means the first boundary condition is substituting in 3.10. Then differentiating the equation after substituting, you will get the this equation. T theta by dx is equal to theta naught m sin hyperbolic mx plus C2 m cos hyperbolic mx. Those two quantities substitute in the second boundary condition. And you will get at x is equal to L, I will get a very lengthy equation. From that you have to separate out C2. C2 is equal to minus theta naught h hyperbolic mx mk plus sin hyperbolic mx divided by mk cos hyperbolic mx plus h sin hyperbolic ml. So these are when x is equal to L you have to substitute. This equation get changed like this. Substituting the value of C1 and C2 in the equation, equation 10 you have to substitute. C1 is equal to theta naught cos hyperbolic mx minus theta naught. It means the C1 value is substituted as theta naught and cos hyperbolic mx it remains same here. And C2 value is theta naught of total quantity whatever is there is substituting into sin hyperbolic mx. So this is what you get. And separating theta from this equation, so you will get the temperature distribution equation in this form fashion. So this is called the equation 3.14. It is called the temperature distribution equation for fines. And this temperature distribution at x is equal to L I given. So for finding out the heat loss by the fin at the tip, consider Fourier's law of thermal conduction. Q fin is equal to minus KAC dT by dx at x is equal to 0 minus KAC d theta by dx is equal to 0. So this is what, wherever t is there, you put theta, it will get. So d theta by dx, x is equal to 0, already known to you, separated out. And after putting C2 in the equation 3.14, you will get this equation. And this is a format I am going to get for conduction heat flow. But the Poddan-Raman, the format is this. This is the same equation, it is distributed like this in page number 50. You can also go through. It is available there. You can also see that this temperature distribution equation is also available there. It only simplified version he has given, but you can also use this or directly you can take the temperature distribution from Poddan-Raman. This is the book. This is what is given in the page number 50 Poddan-Raman. Okay, second to case 2 is over. Now we'll have to come to heat dissipation for the fin at insulated tip. When the tip is insulated, how the tip is insulated? There is no heat flow from the tip. Here it is insulated. D theta by dx is equal to 0. When there is no heat flow, there is no gradient occurs at all. It means there is no temperature difference of temperature between that because it is not exposed to the environment. It is insulated. Completely it is blocked. The heat flow is blocked. So then what is the boundary condition that you have? Theta is equal to theta naught, x is equal to 0, dt by dx is equal to 0 at x is equal to L. Very two boundary conditions I use. Okay. Using equation, first boundary condition, equation 3.1, C1 is equal to 0. when x is equal to 0, c1 is equal to 0 only you get. So in this equation. So again, second, differentiate the equation after putting theta naught. You will get, this is not 0, it is theta naught actually. So by putting that, differentiate the equation above equation once again, and with respect to x, at x is equal to L, later you can put. So therefore, d theta by dx is equal to 0 itself. After differentiation only, you have to put the second boundary condition. D theta by dx is equal to 0. So you will get m theta naught sine hyperbolic mx c2 cos hyperbolic mx when it is 0. So the m is also getting to 0. What you get? C2 is equal to minus theta naught tan hyperbolic ml you are going to get. Okay? So, therefore, substituting back C1 and C2 into equation 3.10, here 3.10, theta by theta naught is equal to cos hyperbolic m l minus x divided by cos ml. This is also given in the data handbook. You can refer and you will get it. So, page number 50, it is given. So, this is the temperature. After that, you have to find the heat flow. Dt by dx or d theta by dx is equal to, in Fourier's law of thermal conduction, you can substitute Kac m theta naught tan hyperbolic ml. It is given in the data handbook. You can also refer it. It is very easy to understand. Once you know the equation 3.10, you can calculate by putting the various boundary condition. Heat dissipation from the fin having a finite length or a long fin. So, having finite length or a long fin, you can, L is sufficiently long. What I am writing, when L is sufficiently long means, we have to have a considerable temperature at the tip of the fin. When x is equal to 0, t is equal to infinity, it is at the base and surrounding temperature is t infinity, that we are going to consider like this. So using a boundary condition, when theta is equal to theta naught at x is equal to 0, theta is equal to 0 at x is equal to L. It means no temperature difference exists at the sufficiently long length. Using boundary condition, you can substitute the first boundary condition, you will get C1 is equal to theta naught, C2 is equal to minus C0 cot hyperbolic ml you get. Okay, substituting these values in the equation, you will get the temperature distribution. And also by using a Fourier's law of conduction, by differentiating the equation 3.18, you will get this. Substituting that, directly you can substitute d theta by dx into this equation and you will get this. And this is also given in the data. So, this is how the derivation is completed. So, then come to the effectiveness of fin. So, the previous four cases I flashed through very fast because the solution and the boundary conditions are different, but methodology of doing the derivation, it remains same. First, you have to find C1 and C2 in from this equation. This is the equation. From this equation, you can find C1 and C2 by using a different boundary condition. And substitute back into the same equation for C1, C2 and separate theta by theta naught, you will get the temperature distribution equation. And also by using Fourier's thermal conduction, d theta by dx, you have to substitute, you will get the heat flow through the fin. Those two are the very important aspects one has to remember. One is temperature distribution, another one is heat flow through the fin when the fin is attached to your wall, and neglecting the resistance between the attached wall and the fin. What is effectiveness of the fin? Effectiveness of fin is defined as ratio of heat lost with fin to the heat lost without fin. It means, suppose heat lost with fin means, say this is the wall and heat is the wall. With fin, what is the amount of heat is going out? This is heat loss with fin. Okay? Heat lost without fin. I don't have any fin, but heat still it is getting removed from the area specified here. So this is also Q fin without fin, previously with fin here. So this ratio, if you consider, that is called effectiveness. Effectiveness So with Finn, the equation already taken from the data handbook, that is KACM theta naught H hyperbolic, it means heat transfer coefficient cos hyperbolic ML plus M into conductivity sin hyperbolic ML divided by M into conductivity cos hyperbolic ML and convection heat transfer coefficient sin hyperbolic ML divided by convection heat transfer coefficient and AC into theta naught. That is without fin any tube surface, if you take the surface area you are going to take and then you are going to do that. So this is the simple equation that is taken care, and then further it is getting simplified and requires some mathematical knowledge to simplify these equations, and different book gives different types of derivation. You can also refer, but solution finally you will get the same whatever the methodology you are going to adopt, but the final solution what the data handbook gives, same solution you are going to get it here. In case of non-dimensional number, that is you have to consider non-dimensional for Biot number, that is H delta by K. What is that H delta by K? Delta by thermal conductivity divided by the convective heat transfer. That means ratio of internal resistance to the external resistance, you call it as. It means how much the material possess internal resistance when the heat is flowing. When the heat is flowing through this, how much is the internal resistance showing to the, how much is the external resistance is opposing to flow into the system from the system to the surrounding, some surrounding to the system. That is analyzed. This is the conduction resistance. This is convection resistance. Okay, defined as the ratio of internal resistance to the external resistance of the fluid or the fin surface, of the fluid on the fin surface. How do you write? By using a non-dimensional number, that is called Biot number. That is called Biot number. Biot number is equal to, that is written abbreviated like this, BI, that is H delta. What is delta? That is H, distance X you can take. Delta is the small length that I am going to take, and that is the K. So how do you write this equation? Delta by K, 1 by H. Any change in the 1 by H, delta by K, 1 by H. This is the internal resistance, this is the external resistance. Internal resistance divided by the external resistance of the fin material, the external resistance of the fluid. Consider different cases for this and then analyze it. So, they consider the following cases. Biot number when it is equal to 0, when this is equal to 0, what is effectiveness that you are going to experience? Effectiveness is equal to 1. Effectiveness equal to 1. There is no use of putting fin because effectiveness is already 100%. It means 1 means there is no use of putting fin on increasing the flow area or the increasing the surface area to flow the heat. This is possible only when poor conducting material is used as a fin. There is no use of putting fin as there is no increase in the heat flow, and it is possible when the poor conducting material is used for the fin. This is what you have to adopt. Let me consider another case. This is the first case. Second case is that Biot number is greater than 1. What is the effectiveness? Effectiveness is always less than 1. Why if it becomes less than 1? Already you know that internal resistance is much more than the lesser than the external resistance. It means there is an adverse effect of heat flow, and fin works as an insulator. Fin works as a insulator. Example, possibly it means the, suppose if you consider steam is flowing through a tube, steam is flowing, water is allowed to flow through the over the tube to condense the steam. What do you get? Heat transfer coefficient of water is more compared to the steam. Steam is just flowing inside and the water is flowing outside the tube. Then the steam, this will having a more heat transfer coefficient. Water is having more heat transfer coefficient. You need not have to have a fin. If you put a fin and it acts as an insulator for conducting heat into the Steve, that is why this is possible. If the value of H is quite high, there is a main. This is the main cause for not using a fins on the steam condenser tube, because of high value of H is in the case of condensation heat transfer. In case of condensation heat transfer, because the water is flowing above the tube and it is having very high heat transfer coefficient than compared to the steam. That is why heat is started flowing in one direction. You don't have to use the fin. That is why whenever you see the condenser tube is not having any fins at all in the power generating units. It means thermal power plants. Basically, you are going to see a big tower, a thermal power plant, and you must have seen that thermal power plant of this nature. This is a cooling tower, and you are using it, and here only the tubes are used like this continuously. These tubes are not having any fins at all. Okay, this is the case. So third case is that when the Biot number is 1 is greater than equal and less than 1. And what is the effectiveness? Effectiveness greater than 1. Which is the most desirable case? This is possible using only high conductivity material like copper, aluminium, and there is, because it is cheaply available, copper, aluminium. You can also use gold, platinum, or any other costly material. Therefore, they are also very good conductor, but copper is the highest thermal conducting material among the non-ferrous metal and also among the ferrous metal. Therefore, in all types of heat exchanger, fins are desirable where there is no difficulty of cleaning or less damage, danger for fouling and damages. All these are considered to be. Best example is radiators that you are going to use. Why, which is the most desirable case I explained, is this is possible using, because the Biot number is less than, greater than 1 is different. Less than 1 means, when it becomes less than 1 Biot number, so this should be very high, the thermal resistance is very high, and if it is more, you will get a lesser number ratio. Ratio is become less, therefore less than 1. Therefore, you have to adopt a fin so that there should not be any resistance to flow. Internal resistance of the conductor is, conductivity is to be increased by applying a fin. If it is less than 1, how to increase? You have to increase the surface area. Then you will get. Okay? This is what, these are the different cases that I have considered. So, what is efficiency? Fin efficiency is defined as actual heat transfer by fin divided by ideal heat transfer. What is actual heat transfer and ideal heat transfer? It means the fin, entire fin is base is maintained at T0. It means the length of the fin, if you consider 10 centimeter or 10 millimeter or whatever the size you consider, that surface should be entirely maintained with the base temperature. If the base temperature is 100, entire fin assumed to be 100 throughout. That is called Q fin. So what is ideal entire fin? What is ideal? And we are considering the ideal fin. Heat transfer. If the entire fin surface is maintained at base temperature, so this is what the Q fin means. Last definition I have taken, last derivation, and sufficient length of the fin is taken. So area profile and m theta naught 10 hyperbolic ml divided by the ideal heat transfer AFH theta naught. Why AFH theta naught is taken? Material constant you are not taken there, and it is ideal heat transfer. So the efficiency of fin is always the efficiency, the fin amount of heat flow through the fin. Consider this equation. Heat flow through the fin is the efficiency of the fin multiplied by the ideal flow. This is what the equation are going to be. Very simple. You have to remember these two definitions. I'm going to the next. And I am going to solve few problems out of that by taking the definition and the equations from the data handbook. I am going bit fast. If you want, you can repeatedly refer the definitions and also try to solve the problem on your own. And also the derivation, much important is that any one derivation they are going to ask in the examination for 8 to 10 marks. Among the four cases which I explained, one is infinite long fin, another one is convection boundary condition. Second one is fin is insulated, and fourth one is fin is having infinite length. It means sufficiently long length. Okay, your four cases are there. All the four cases The final equations are given in the data handbook, but not as you derive. You can also simplify and get back to the derivation, what the equation what he has given in the data handbook. But it needs little patience to do that. And the only thing is you have to remember any equation that you are going to derive. First you have to derive. First you have to assume the boundary condition. It means what boundary condition you want to, what is the condition he has asked in the examination, which case you want to solve and find out. He is going to ask one temperature distribution and also heat transfer. So right from the beginning of the class, I am telling you in conduction, only two things you have to remember. One is temperature distribution equation you have to solve. Another one is heat flow equation that you have to solve. Okay. Example I am going to take. One end of long aluminium rod is connected to a wall at 140 degree as shown in figure. One end of the rod is attached to a wall. Other end is protrudes into a room where air temperature is 15 degree, protrudes and it is projected. The rod is 3 millimeter in diameter and heat transfer coefficient between the rod surface and environment is 300 watt per meter square degree Celsius. Estimate the total heat dissipated by the rod taking the thermal conductivity as 150 watts per meter degree Celsius. So there are all the properties are given. The temperature of the base is given, that is 140, that is T0 or TB you can take. And T infinity is 15 degree, that is surrounding temperature of the room is given. Diameter is 0.003 millimeter and the heat transfer coefficient H is equal to 300 watt per meter square degree Celsius. Conductivity is 150 watt per meter degree Celsius. So most of the students may not write the unit. First you have to write how to, anything you write, it should have a specific meaning for that. And H only 300 if you write, it doesn't give any meaning. It will never give any meaning unless you specify that. That is the unit of convection heat transfer coefficient watt per meter square degree Celsius. Conductivity K is 150 watt per meter degree Celsius. P is the perimeter, pi into diameter of the this thing, you will get 9.428 into raised to minus 3 meter. Area is a cross section, pi by 4 and pi d square by 4. So that is meter square area you get. So Q fin directly you can substitute, because what is the length he has given? 3 millimeter. As you mentioned, which case you are going to study among, consider among all the four cases which I discussed now. One end protrudes into a room whose air temperature is 150. He has not specified any temperature. For that, you are going to directly use a simple equation, that is finite length and exposed to air with convective heat transfer coefficient. So this equation I am going to use and then substitute all the values. You will get 6.843 watt of energy dissipated by using these boundary conditions, convective boundary condition, also temperature distribution values. Okay, this is very simple equation. So another one example, this is also an examination question paper, the previous, and it is a old question paper that is why I did not mention, but all the questions which I have taken from examination only, probable typical type of examination question paper. And questions also very tricky in nature, and one has to apply mind to first you find out the physical situation and create a geometry and then understand, start analyzing and working out by considering the appropriate boundary condition and select the suitable equation from data handbook, substitute appropriately and properly or to calculate, and then you'll get the answer. Write the correct unit, then only you'll get a good marks. Otherwise, simply selecting some equation and substituting and wrongly calculating and putting wrong answer, you won't get anything. That is why it requires a lot of practice, use of calculator with this heat transfer, because the equations looks so simple. After substitution, only one unit should maintain. That is, all values should be in meter degree Celsius, watt per meter degree Celsius only. Okay, lengths are converted into meter and then substituted back. Suppose you equation an electric motor drives a centrifugal pump which circulates a hot liquid metal of 480 degree. It means mercury. Hot liquid metal is mercury, 480 degree Celsius. Motor is coupled to a pump impeller by horizontal steel shaft. That conductivity is 32 watt per meter degree Celsius. 25 millimeter in diameter shaft is connected. If the ambient air is 20 degree Celsius, temperature of the motor is limited to a maximum value of 55 degree Celsius. The heat transfer coefficient between the steel shaft and ambient air is 14.8 watt per meter square degree Celsius. What will be the length of shaft should be specified between the motor and because to maintain this temperature, what should be the length? He is asking L. It means all the parameter is given, asking you the length of the fin you have to calculate. So heat is transferred from pump towards the motor as well as to the surrounding is the case. Length of the shaft can be decided by assuming the tip of the shaft connected to a motor is insulated for the above case. It means why it should not go beyond 55 degree. That is why it is assumed that insulated case, and case 2 we can take. That is, so this is what the assumption made. This is the end insulated at the motor and this is the pump and it is having temperature. Because 20 degree minus you will get theta naught is equal to 460, T minus T infinity, that theta L is 35 degree, and this is the diameter and this is the length I have taken, L, 0 to L. This act as a fin because it is very hot and this shaft itself is a fin and you have to calculate the length of the shaft. This is very beautiful example. So all the parameters and data are given here. TW is the 20 degree. And H is convective transfer coefficient of air surrounding the pump and motor. And T0 is 480, TL is 55 degree Celsius. You will get what is the difference in temperature? TL is T infinity minus the surrounding temperature, that is 35 degree. And T theta, T0 minus T wall is 460 degree. Substitute those two values in this. And consider the fin is having insulated tip, you will get the answer like this. You will get ML value. ML value you get, after getting ML, you can substitute M value in this and calculate this. You will get L is equal to 0.351 meter. This is the length. So time is up. I am going to wind up the class today. We will meet you next time. The next day tomorrow I am going to meet you. Thank you very much. And I request all the student to go through the derivation which I have given. It is already every day I am transferring my lecture to the VTU Regional Center Mysore. You can ask for the video lecture. You can go through repeatedly. If you have got any doubt, you can raise the question. So thank you very much for patient hearing.